Good morning, you filthy plumbers. Today is a snow day.
You see, the thing about snow days is you're both really excited and kind of anxious about them happening to you. And that makes sense, right? I mean, the inner kid in you is like, oh, this is so exciting. We get to do snow forts, snow angels, snowmen, snowball fights. But the adult inside you, the adult is thinking, man, today's gonna be a rough day. And I mean, it's a pretty rough day. They're calling for something like 10 centimeters of snow. You know, you're thinking to yourself, okay, the cars are gonna be sliding, there's gonna be a ton of traffic, everything's gonna be moving slow. But the good thing is, everybody is thinking that. Which brings me to my next point. All of our work today got canceled. And that's sort of the thing you have to really worry about as a service plumber. Sometimes you have days like this in Canada where everybody knows it's gonna snow and it's gonna come down and it's gonna be centimeters, inches, feet, who knows? And at some point your customer's gonna call you up and say, look, you know that thing we had to do today? You know that toilet that you have to replace? Well, we got another one just sitting there. So if you're not doing anything tomorrow, why don't you guys come over tomorrow and replace this one for us? So it's both a curse and a blessing, because that was money you could have had today, and it was also a job you didn't have to do tomorrow. But you have to work at the customer's schedule. That's sort of how it goes in this line of work. You know what I'm saying? So for most of us that get that call, we say to ourselves, you know what? Okay, we get to sit at home, relax. But a plumbing YouTuber thinks to himself, all right, we can do a delicious vlog. Let's go. I'ma wake up to bench, join them subs, he's bored, working on any more though. I'ma wake up to bench, join them subs, he's bored, working on any more though.
Coming down out there, pretty rough. 10 centimeters is turning into 20 right now. Let's talk about what's going on in this video. peeps, in this video, a couple of weeks back, we got a call from a customer that was essentially saying that their laundry room drain was completely clogged. And we're talking about the laundry tub itself that was completely clogged. So I went out that very same night. It was on the weekend, it was a Saturday night, and I went out and I started using the K50 on it. And I sent the K50 in, and I spent probably a half an hour to 45 minutes trying to get one simple coil to get into this pipe and as far as it can so that I could connect the second coil. But man, let me tell you, it was not budging whatsoever. So after about 45 minutes of fighting and sweating, I just came to realize, like, look, we're dealing with a major issue here. The K50 is usually really good at getting through 1.5 and 2 inch drains. That's typically what it's designed to do. And then I came to realize that as we're pulling the snake out, it's coming out with a little bit of a muddy consistency. So it almost looked like it was either mud coming out or grout or something of the sort. Something that was not natural of what should be typically going inside your drain. So I had to turn to the customer and give them their options and essentially say, look, we're potentially dealing with a collapsed pipe or somebody threw grout or cement inside, or we're dealing with just a severe clog that's happened over time. And you know, after the initial panic settles down with the customers, you eventually say, okay, look, it's not a big deal. Don't worry. We got to come in and we got to do this work that we're doing in this video that you see right here. So once we took this pipe out, we came to realize that it was a solid clog. So as you can see inside this footage right here, there's no way that the K50 was gonna be able to get through there. It is nothing but a brick wall. So as you see inside this video right here, we have three different materials that we're working with. We have actually four different materials that we're working with. The stack initially was copper and it was about 1.5 inches, and then it went ABS, which was also 1.5 inches, and the 1.5 inch ABS then went to a section of 3 inch cast iron, which went underground, and then it went to 4 inch clay. And that is something I haven't seen in a really long time. Clay pipe is something typically used a long, long time ago, and clay pipes over time tend to become brittle and break so that roots can actually get into them and start growing within the clay. That's typically what we find inside clay pipes. Now, in this example right here, we don't find many roots whatsoever. Whatever was in that drain was essentially hardening over time, and over time, the diameter of the pipe on the inside just kept getting smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller to the point where water couldn't even get through anymore. Now, this is typical of cast iron. Cast iron has a really tough interior, so what will end up happening over time is that whatever debris is getting in there will get caught along the way, and then the inside diameter will start to shrink. We don't typically use cast iron anymore underground. I think there are still places that do and some companies that do, but whenever Dad and I are doing undergrounds, you always see us using some sort of PVC plastic pipe. A lot of times we use ABS, and inside this video you're gonna see the repair is the majority is ABS all the way up to the stack. And we do that for a couple of reasons. The first reason is it's really cost efficient. ABS is one of the cheaper materials that you can buy that is also legal to put under the ground. The other reason is because plastic is a very smooth interior, so you're not going to run into this issue quite as often as you are with cast iron, which has a rough surface on the inside. The third reason we use ABS underground and plastics underground is they're typically pretty strong materials and they last a pretty long time. So overall, it's just a really good material to use for this sort of thing.
Well, all right, that's it for me then. Just another day in the life of a stranded plumber at home in a snowstorm. Do me a favor, if you like this video, smash that thumbs up button, share with your friends if you know people that would enjoy this, and I'll see you plumbers very soon. Kenny Molotov, guys.